Creek Kids, I'm so excited you're here today. We have an amazing Bible story. It's about a new king. Now, the last few weeks we've been learning all about King David, but today we're going to learn about his son. But I'm not going to tell you his name until Handsome Henry gets here. Boys and girls, will you count with me? Let's call our handsome friend out. Are you ready? One, two, three. Henry!
Hi, boys and girls. Oh, hi, Miss Sue.
Hi. Henry, your hair looks great today.
Thank you so much. Well, you know, these last few days, it's been rainy and stormy. And, you know, it's just out of control.
I tell you, it looks fabulous today. You have a lot of life in it.
Well, you know, I thought maybe spike it up.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes I just don't know what to do with it.
Looking good, buddy.
Thanks.
Hey, do you want to pray with us?
Yeah, let's pray.
Okay, are you ready, boys and girls? You know what to do. We're going to fold our hands, bow our head, and we're going to talk to the Lord. Are you ready? Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this good day. Thank you for our Creek Kids, for their mommies, their daddies. Thank you that we will be able to come back to church next month. We love you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, my
goodness.
That was
a good prayer. Yeah, I heard we get to see all our friends again in July.
Yes.
Oh, it's going to be so great.
Oh, my goodness. I cannot wait. Can I give you a hug?
Of course, Miss Sue.
Oh, it's so good to see you, buddy. I just love you.
It's so good to see you. Thanks.
Okay. You're welcome. Hey, Henry, I have a sad Bible story.
Oh,
well,
no.
It's going to start sad, and then it's going to get happy.
Oh, okay. Those are my favorite kinds.
Well, this is from the book of 1 Kings, which is in the Old Testament, and it's chapter 3. Now, King David, remember all about King David. He started out a shepherd boy.
Yeah, and Goliath.
That's
and,
right.
Yeah.
And then who was that mean old king who was chasing him? Do you remember? King
Solomon?
Close.
Oh.
King Saul.
Saul.
Was King Saul right. was chasing him.
I knew it was an S.
Well, after King David died, his son became king.
Oh, that's right.
That's right. And King David had said, the next king after me is going to be my son Solomon.
That's right. Solomon was David's son.
That's right, buddy. Well, this Bible story is amazing. Are you ready? I'm going to read a little bit of this. This is from 1 Kings. Solomon asks for wisdom. When David died, his son Solomon became king. One night, God appeared to Solomon in a dream.
What?
I know, right? God told Solomon to ask for anything he wanted.
Wait.
Anything at all. Anything.
Now, like?
Anything.
He could ask for all the candy he wants?
He could.
Or all the soda he wants?
Oh, yes.
But did he ask for those things?
No.
No?
What else?
What about money?
Oh, that's
did he ask for money?
He didn't ask for money.
What?
What about a new fancy truck? Do you think he wanted one of those?
Oh my gosh, a new fancy truck would be so cool.
Right?
Yeah.
No. Listen to this. Solomon could have asked for power or riches or a very long life, but instead, Solomon asked that God would give him wisdom. Huh. Wisdom. Wisdom means to just be wise.
To just be smart and know the difference between right and wrong.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Very good, Henry.
Thanks.
Right. And he asked for wisdom. And God gave him great wisdom. He was super, super wise. He made great decisions.
Wow.
I'm going to tell you something crazy that happened. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Well, this mommy, there were two mommies in our Bible story. One had a little baby.
Oh.
And the other one didn't have a baby. And she wanted the one lady's baby.
What?
So she lied. And she said, that's my baby. And the mama, she said, no, this is my baby. And they were arguing. So they had to go and stand before King Solomon. And King Solomon knew exactly what to do. You see, both of the women told him, "This is my baby." And they were serious.
Oh, man.
So what I'm going to tell you is shocking.
Wow. How did he figure it out? Are you going to tell us how he figured it
out? I am.
King, I can't wait.
King Solomon said, "You both say the baby is yours? Let's cut the baby in half, and you can each have half of the baby."
What?
The one mommy said, "Don't do it. That is my baby. Don't do it. Just give my baby to the other woman." And King Solomon knew immediately, that is the mommy. That is the mommy.
Yep.
And because she didn't want her baby to get hurt. She wanted her baby to be safe. King Solomon figured out how to tell which lady was lying.
That was super smart.
Very smart.
Yeah.
And I hope the other lady got in trouble, because she was basically stealing a baby and then lying about it.
Yeah, that's not nice at all.
No, that's not nice. That's sin, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, we've been talking about sin. We talk about sin quite a bit. Do you remember what a sin is, Henry?
Well, it's anything you say, or anything you do, or anything you think that disobeys God.
Good job, Henry. Yeah. That's right.
You taught me that.
I'm so glad you remembered.
Yeah.
Well, Henry, those two ladies, one was telling the truth, one was lying.
Right.
And King Solomon figured it out. And how did he do that? Because God made him wise. Super wise.
Super wise. That was a super smart idea.
It really was.
Yeah.
He knew. Because mamas love their babies more than, you know, mm-hmm. anything on this earth. They love their kids and they mm-hmm. want to protect them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, our next Bible story next week, friends, is about a person named, are you ready for this?
Yeah.
I'm going to whisper it in my ear, in your ear, and then you tell everybody, okay?
Okay.
Jehoshaphat.
What?
Can you say his name?
Jehoshaphat?
Yes, isn't that a hard name to say?
That's like five syllables. Jehoshaphat. Oh my goodness.
I think it's four. Jehoshaphat. Yep, four.
Wow, that's a long name.
Jehoshaphat. We're going to learn all about him next week, boys and girls.
Wow.
Will you come back?
I can't wait.
I know, I'm so excited. Boys and girls, our little Creek kids, will you come back here next week so Henry and I can talk to you about a fella?
Yeah.
By the name of, what's his name, Henry?
Jehoshaphat.
That's right. We'll see you right here, Creek Kids, next week. Bye, friends.
Bye, boys and girls.